Hello everyone. What a beautiful day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in our great and mighty God. Welcome again to this time we have together to share the word of God, to pray and to lift our hands and to worship and exalt our great King. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for a time like this that we can be able to minister to your people. And Lord, I pray that everyone that will be watching this and hearing this will be blessed today. Father God, I pray that you minister to everyone. Oh God, let your spirit reign powerfully. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, people of God, the good thing about what God is doing nowadays is that everywhere we turn, we can see signs and signs and revelations of God's move in our life. And I know that many people are wondering and saying, why do you say that in the midst of the pandemic, in the midst of the difficulties going on? But I believe that everything that happens to us or whatever is happening today, God is in full control. God is not taken unawares by what is happening. God is not, taken by surprise by what is happening. He knows everything that's happening. And that is why I believe that we got to remember, turn to the word of God. I want to read the word of God to you this day. It's from the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3. And the Bible says in verse 1, to everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. If we just stop there for a while, to everything, there is a time and there's a season. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck. A time that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break and a time to build up. You know, friends, a time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. You know, friends, the Bible is very, very simple to understand. It's very clear to us. Everything that is going on in our world today, there's a time for everything. A time. And the time we are right now is a time of great trials, a time of great shaking, a time of great tribulation, a time of great shifting around. What are we going to do with our time? And one of the things that really came into my heart this morning as I was praying about this was that, you know, many people say, well, I don't have time, I don't have time, I don't have time, I don't have time, I don't have time. And we'll hear it many minutes, I don't have time. But all of a sudden, the time now is available for you now. I don't have time to spend with my kids. I'm too busy working. But now you are home with your kids. Are they annoying you right now? Are you feeling so fed up of them now? It's time to spend with your husband. It's time to spend with your family. It's time to teach that your daughter, that thing you always wanted to teach your daughter. It's time now to teach your son that gardening tools. Those things you always wanted to teach your family. Now is the time to do that. But instead of doing that, we complain, we grumble, we mumble, and even the kids around us, we drive them away. But let's look at it. That is why I say everything that happens, happens for a reason. There's a purpose behind it. Now you got the time with your family. You got the time with your wife. You always wanted to show your wife how much you love her. It is time to show that love to her. You always wanted to show your husband, your spouse, or people around you how much you love them. Now you are together. You are locked up in the house. You can't go anywhere. You can't go to work. You can only go to the shop or do some other things. Now you can say to your wife and to your family, let me show you how much I love you. Because this is the time now that you can be able to spend together in prayer, in family worship, in devotion, a time to lift up the name above all names, a time to really see what God is to you. But friends, if we don't take advantage of that time, the time will pass all on and we'll keep on the same thing we are. The Bible says a time to do everything, a time to die. Friend, a time to live. Friend, the time we are living in now is a time for us to remember that everything in our life, it belongs to the Lord God Almighty. We are living by Him. Friends, in the time of pandemic, it's not a time to get discouraged or a time to get annoyed with God or annoyed with the church or a time to backslide. No, it's a time to exalt the Father, a time to lift up our hands and say, I will praise you, oh my God. I will exalt you, oh my King. I will magnify you all the days of my life. Instead of going down and feeling sorry for yourself and saying, I don't know what is going on, things are going bad, you use this time as a time to lift up that wonderful name. You live this time to to exhort the father. You use this time to pray with your family, to pray with your wife, to pray with your children, to lift up that altar. Hallelujah. The altar in your house that have been polluted by television and all the worldly amusement. It's time to clean up that altar. It's time to say the altar of God will be built again in our house. That is the time that God is calling us to come back to. A time to build. A time to ask God to refill us. That is what I believe, that even what you see right now, people are making so many theories. So many voices are coming. Voices from here, from there, from there. You change your Facebook or your YouTube or any tube you turn on. There are many, many voices telling you many versions of the pandemic. And people saying that, people, and everything is confusing our mind. We put our head, and, oh, how many confusion. But if you only can look at the great side of this thing, that God has given you this time now to enjoy with your family. We may never have a time like this again after this, but we don't know what is going to happen. But friend, the time we have right now, let us not complain. Let us not become complacent. Let us not become so, detached. Let us use this time to draw closer to the Father. Oh, my brother, my sister, I know before the pandemic, many people say, well, if I only have 3 hours in the day, I will teach my daughter how to cook. I will teach my son how to do gardening. I will do this, I will do that. But now you have the time to do that. You say, but I go to work. Yes, you go to work. But the good thing also is that when you come back from work, your family, they are there. You can now show them how great and how mighty things they are. You can tell them the values. You can teach them that valuable thing. Your kids are one, they want to know the value. What you stand for, it's time for you to lift your hand and teach them those things. Because friend, this is the time now for us to release that. It's time now for us to show them the great and the mighty things of our God. Your kids may not know your story. They may not know where you come from. Your family, your friends, they may not know who you are. They may not even know what is your stand. They may not know where you are coming from, your background. Why do you believe in God? Why did you become saved? It is time now to explain to your family, instead of pushing your children away and saying you are making noise, you are disturbing me. Find time right now to explain to them the reason for the hope in you. The hope in you. Why do you believe in Jesus? Why do you do what you do? Why do you go to church? Explain to them. Let your children know. Draw them closer. Your children are not a burden. They're not a burden. Your family are not a burden. They're a blessing. And so the time we have right now, the way I look at it, we are in a very critical time. A time for us to establish again the very altars of God. A time for us to establish again the very structures of God. The structure that have been broken by pride, by arrogance, by evil, by demonic powers, it's been broken down. Now God is giving us a time to build it again. Let's do that with our family. Let's tell our children that, giving to God, serving God, the house of God, these are the things we do. We don't go to do other things on the day of the Lord. We do it. And this is the challenging thing. On the Sunday morning, your children will be watching you. They want to see if you will tune into the kingdom of God, to the word of God, to the online services. Because you say, well, we are not in church now. What do we do now? It's time for us to build. It's time for us to strengthen. It's time for us to rise up. It's time for us to be prayerful. It's time for us to work for the kingdom of God. You know what the Bible says? The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, friends, one of the things I like about it says, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. It's a time for you to gather together and gather. Oh, make a hedge around your family. Hallelujah. Make a hedge. I said, demons, you will not touch my brother. You will not touch my sister. A time to make a hedge. A time to build an altar in your living room. A time to build an altar in your home. A time to build an altar in your country. A time to build an altar in wherever you are. A time to lift up at that name. You know, friend, the Bible says, a time to get up and a time we need to speak about the goodness of our God is now. I'm loving this scripture. As I'm reading this scripture, I'm so excited because everything the Bible says here is so true. It's a time for us to gather. A time for us to let the young generation know what we stand for. A time for us to let the people around us know what we stand for. It's not a time to backslide. It's not a time to look at evil. It's a time to really stand firm in our days. To everything on the earth, there's a season for everything. The season we are living now is a season of repentance, a season of asking God to fill us with his power. You know, friend, one of the things I want to challenge you about right now is this. You know, people complain, they are depressed, they are tired, they are oppressed, their lockdown is killing them and all. But I want you to look at this from a different perspective. Maybe for a very long time, you didn't have that time to really spend with God in prayer. You wake up in the morning, hurry, hurry, hurry to job. You know, you come back, hurry, hurry to cook. But now, at least in your home, you can have it. You can be able to do a bit of your job or whatever you're doing, online working, if you're working from home, but you have a bit of time or some time to spare to speak to Father before you start your job, to let your children know where you stand. It's a time to build. It's a time to do the things we always wanted to do. It's a time for us to exalt the name of the Father. It's a time for us to lift up high. It's a time for us to allow God to minister to us. It's a time for us to really shine the light of God's glory. Hallelujah. I'll keep on reading this morning because I'm excited about this time. It's a time for us to make sure that everything we do, you know, whatever we do in the kingdom of God, even when we are doing what we're doing, it's a time for us to allow God to really shine the power of our earth. It's a time to allow God to move. Friend, let me read this scripture for you. Hallelujah. Let me read it for you. The Bible says, yeah, the Bible says, it says that for every reason, there's a time for everything under heaven. It says that a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. You know, friends, the people make in the time of peace, people prepare for war. Let me repeat that. A time of peace, people prepare for war. Because the time we are living now, there is going to be a massive upheaval after all this. The Bible tells us that we are living in the end times. We don't know what is going to happen in the next few days, the next few years. But I can tell you right now, the world is not going to get better. There is massive persecution, massive trouble coming. It is now time for us to sit down and establish ourselves and deep our roots on the word of the living God. It's time for us to be deeper, deeper, deeper. You that never studied the Bible, it's time for you to study the Bible. You that never went into prayer, you only pray 2 minutes a day, it is time for you to spend time in praying to God. Spend time, 25, half an hour, 1 hour. Spend that time really talking to God and ground your roots in the word of God. And make you strong, and make you, you know, continuously strong. Because I believe very strongly that if we don't do that, the time will pass by, and we'll say, what happened to us? All of a sudden, what happened to us? All of a sudden, we are saying to ourselves, oh, if we knew, we should have taken advantage of the pandemic and really spend more time with the Father. But it's now time for you to spend time with the Father. It's time for you to spend that time and just allow the Father to help you, allow him to bless you, allow him to keep you, allow him to strengthen you. The time we are living in right now, it's time for us to really gather our family. Maybe you are a grandmother, maybe you are a grandfather. Begin to sow the seed of the word of God into your grandchildren's life. You know, friend, maybe you are a father right now. You are locked up in your home. You can't go anywhere, but your children are with you. Get those children right now and begin to let them understand the principles of prayer, the principles of the word of God. Why God speaks to us about prayer, you got to study that as well. But then you know what, friend? You cannot give what you don't have. That is why you got to do it for yourself. For a very long time, we've relied on preachers, prophets, and people do it for us. Friend, now you can do it for yourself. You can sit in your living room and you can call upon the name of the Lord God Almighty. For the Bible says, call upon me in the day of your trials and I will hear you. Call upon me in the day of your difficulty, I will hear you. Call upon me. That's the promise that God said. He didn't say prophet only. He didn't say teachers only. He said, anyone, for whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That includes you. That includes me. So let's take time right now. Let's take time aside. Let's quieten. Let's shut the voice of the discouragement. Let's shut the voice of the world. Let's shut down the voice of the noise. And let's come before the Father and let God build us stronger. Let us be so strong that when the pandemic finishes or when things happen again, we will not be shaken. So many Christians are shaking. They are shaking. They are shaking. They are crying. They say, oh, we don't know what's going to happen right now. But if you know the God you are serving, in the midst of the pandemic, in the midst of the tribulation, in the midst of the shaking, you will still arise and give glory to God. Like I said a few days ago, you are crying about the pandemic, that people are losing their job and things are happening. But in the same pandemic, people are getting blessed, people are buying new houses, people are buying new cars. The same pandemic, people are getting hit, and so many things are happening. Don't let this pandemic destroy your time with the Lord. Don't let it be a time to waste. No, don't waste that time, especially with families, fathers and mothers. Father, it's not a time to start being abusive to your family. It's not a time, because you are in the same space. It's not a time. Turn that time into a time of praise and worship. There are so many praise and worship you can do today. Praise God with your family. Exalt God with your family. Let them know who you are. Let them know the God you serve. So many of our children just go to church. They don't even know why. Let them know why you believe in God. Let them know why you serve God. Let them know why you pray. It's your time now to instruct your children. It's your time now to give them the word. A time to build. A time to build. Even though the word may say we are finished, the Bible says, greater is he on the inside of me. We are not finished. We are going stronger. We are going mightier. We are rising higher. You know, somebody said to me this morning, oh, Pastor William, is this the last days? Is this the Antichrist? Is this that? And I'm looking at this person and I say, one thing to say, whether it's Antichrist or not, it's not the issue, and I don't believe it's Antichrist yet, but the issue is that God is warning us as a church, and God is telling us, look at this right now, every single thing that is happening right now is preparing us for the coming of Christ. You can't buy or sell without the mark. Look at what they are doing right now with the medicine. You can't buy or sell without that. You can't work without that. And all these mandates by government, God is just showing us that these are the things that are going to happen. So friends, you who know the Bible, you who know the word, it is time to really, really, really put it in your heart and be strong, so that when that time comes, you will be raptured and you will not be facing all the things that the enemy is bringing upon this generation. Friends, can I say this to you right now? I know that some people may say, but why are you talking so much about these things? I strongly believe it's time for us to arrive. I believe we as a church, we have spent so much time in stupid things. We spent so much time arguing about the building, about the color of the building, about the some of the things, about the carpet. Why? Oh, no, you paint this thing red. Paint it white. No. Don't forget about the painting. Forget about the carpet. Let's deal with the soul of man. Let's ask God to fill our life, our children, our homes with the power of the Most High. Let us come back to the prayer altar. Why is it that many people spend time arguing about the color of the carpet of the church, and they spend very little time in prayer? I see it between my eyes. Men of God who are supposed to be leading churches in prayer, they are, you know, speaking words, are empty words, empty words. Where is the prayer power of the church? Where is the church people? And that is what I'm really concerned, that we as a church, we got to rise up. You as a family, you got to rise up and let the time you use be time to bless the name of the Lord. Not time for alcohol and abuse. I know that some people are getting snap and getting many snap, and they drink and they're being abusive. No, that's not the time. Turn around, my brother, my sister. Turn around. Let us use this time to glorify our God. Let us use this time to exalt our God. Let us use this time to really ask God to help us. Let us use this time to shine the light of Jesus. Let us use this time to lift up that name. Let us use this time to establish the kingdom of God in our home, in your home, in your environment, everywhere you go. Let people see, because the time you have now in your closet, if you don't draw to God in your closet, you can't draw to God outside here. So the time that God is giving to us now during this lockup or lockdown or lock-in is time for us to really consecrate ourselves before the Father. As somebody said, but Pastor, how do I do that? Let me tell you what the Bible said. Bible said, it said, submit yourself to God. I think it's James chapter 5, verse 8. Submit yourself to God, draw nearer to God, and he will draw nearer to you. It's that simple. If you want to do that right now, you can start again by getting Bible exposition. Start reading, start studying the Bible, start coming to prayer, start worshiping the Father. Go deeper. Somebody say, go deeper. Go deeper and go deeper. Stop scratching the surface only. Surface. You know, many people are like that. They're just happy with, I attend online meeting the 2 hours, and that's all for the week. Come on, you cannot be able to defeat sickness sickness by that. You can't defeat witchcraft with that. You can't defeat the enemy with that. You got to go deeper and deeper and deeper. Because when you go deeper, then you can understand the mysteries of the kingdom of God. Then you can be able to stand firm and the anointing will flow in your life because you are deeper. The deeper you go, the more you see the revelation. The deeper you go, the more you see goodness. You know, many people today, I feel so sorry. I feel sad when I hear the atrocities, when I hear the various things that are happening around the world. Suicide and demonic oppression, people taking their lives because they are fed up of life. No, brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you. There's a brighter side of life. God has given us the victory. You don't need to take your life. You don't need to be so down. God Almighty can say, reach unto me, call upon me, I will hear you. Suicide is not the answer. There's a better blessing coming if we can only remember and turn a time to heal, a time to rejoice, a time to look to our Father, a time to exalt the Father, a time to come out and magnify the Lord, a time to really speak of the mercies, of the goodness of the Lord. I want to challenge you right now, my brother, my sister, use this time of lockdown or lock-in or lock-up to really establish something. Maybe you always wanted to do a Bible course. There's thousands of Bible courses online that are even free. Use this time to study the Bible. Get that Bible training. Use this time to do it. Maybe you wanted to always be a prayer warrior. You always pray two minutes and that's all. But you always wanted to go deeper. There are churches, there are Christian organizations that are doing prayer on Zoom or on Facebook. Join them so you can experience what it means to pray for half an hour. My brother, my sister, a man that have experienced with God, a man that have experienced God's power, will never be the same. Oh, hallelujah. When you experience the power of prayer, the power of being close to Him, the power of knowing who He is, He opens your eyes, He breaks the chains, you will never be the same again. That is why the Bible says, draw near to me, I will draw near to you. God is still calling you and calling you and calling you and calling you. It is time. It is time for us to respond. The reality is that today, God has given us that ability. I plead with you, my brother, my sister. I plead with you. Don't let this pandemic lockdown be wasted just eating junk food and watching television all day. No, close that television set. Spend time with the Father. Get matured. Get released. Get your blessing. I said to somebody, you know, you don't always need somebody to pray for you. You can pray for yourself. You can. He said, how do I do that? I said, when you really know who God is, you can lay hands on yourself and say, headache in the name of Jesus, I command you to go. When you really know God, who God is, you can lay hands on your pocket. You can pray for yourself because the Bible says, call upon me, all ye who labor and are laden, and I will give you rest. All of us can pray for ourselves. We can all pray and ask God to help us. And God is powerful and powerful enough to help us. He will lift us high. He will help us. He will deliver us. That is why the Bible says, His name shall be called Wonderful, Marvelous, the King of Glory. Can I say a few words right now to those who are consuming alcohol and being abusive? You got to turn around. Life is not about hitting other people or about being abusive. Life is about being a blessing. You know, that's your daughter, that's your child that you have always neglected. Now you are in the same house with them 24/7. You can't even go to work or you can't go anywhere. You work at home. Draw them closer. Let them know the type of a person you are. Let them know that you serve God. Friend, you can do it today. Oh, but I don't have the ability. Who has the ability? Nobody has the ability. If we try, and we try, and we try. A step is all we need to take. And a little step today goes a long way. There's a daughter crying out for the father's love. There's a father, a son crying out for the mother and the father's love. It's time to draw them closer together. Let us be a family. It's time to build. It's time to pray. It's time to rejoice. It's time to tell the devil enough is enough. It's time to kick the devil out of town. It's time to shine the light of God. It's time to pray. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. People of God, I thank God for what God is going to do in your life. I really encourage you right now. Let us lift our soul before the Lord and let God be glorified. In His time, it is time. You say, but Pastor, how do you know? Because when you look around you, you see the things that are happening around you. You wonder the evil that's happening. God has already wonders of what is going to happen. This pandemic did not take God by surprise. Everything happening today is in the word of God. In Matthew 24, he said that in the last days, this shall happen. You go and read it in your Bible. Then he says something. He says, be careful that no man deceive you. Look at the rate of deception. Look at all the conspiracy all around there. Christians being deceived up and down, up and down. Why? Because they don't study their word. They are bringing things that are not even godly. Let us go back and see the mind of God. What is God saying about pandemic? What is God saying about all these things? Let us seek his face. Let us ask him instead of just making up our own human and man-made ideas that will corrupt people's life. I pray to God that this short message or this short encounter will bless you, and you'll be able to be blessed, and you'll be able to rise up and do greater things and also understand more from this. I pray that, you know, you spend that time seeking the Lord. I pray you spend that time really coming to the Lord. I pray that this time will be a time for you to really relax in the presence of God. If you don't know how to study your Bible, let me give you one small example. Get the Bible. You know, read it once. Don't read a long chapter. Get a concise chapter. Start from the book of John. Read it. Get a pen and a paper and write down the things that make sense to you. Write down the scripture. Write it all down. There's a scripture you can memorize. Write it down. When you write it down, you read it again and again and again, it becomes part of you. You are bringing the word into your heart. And then you pray. Oh, but I don't know how to pray. Prayer is not hard. It's just talking to God. As I'm talking to this camera right now, prayer is talking to God. You've talked to God. Talk to him about anything. Talk to him about your life, about what is going on in your life. As you talk to the Father, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, you come to develop an intimacy with him. Think about it right now. You know when you're talking to your dad, yeah? Your earthly father. You spend time with your earthly father. The more you spend time with your earthly father, the more you draw closer to them. The more you draw closer to them, the more you got to know what they like. People who are close to me know one thing for sure. Of all the food, I don't eat cheese. People know who are, only those who are closer to me knows that. Now you know, yeah? I don't eat cheese. So people who are close to me know that. But if you are not close to me, you will never know that. That is what we go. We draw closer and we draw closer and we draw closer and we draw closer. And because of that, we come to see the goodness of the Lord and the mercy of the Lord. It's your time, brother and sister, to rise. This is your time to rise. You take this time to rise. Rise up. Rise up. Rise up and shine. Rise up and give God the glory. Rise up and declare that you are more than a conqueror. Rise up and make noise and let God Almighty be glorified. Rise up, my brother. Rise up. Don't let the pandemic dictate or rewrite your life. In Jesus' name, I rebuke that. Don't let the pandemic stop you from doing what God called you to do. Don't let the pandemic take you off the track. Don't let the pandemic stop the work of God in your life. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. God Almighty will be exalted in your life as you begin to draw closer to him. It's time to pray. It's time to draw closer. It's time to sow. It's time to be effective. It's time to get on board. It's time to continuously pray. You know, people say to me every time before we pray right now that, oh, Pastor William, I pray before nothing happens. Pray again and again and again. I say that is pray until something happens. Push. Pray until something happens. You pray today, you pray again and again and again. And one day, the Holy Ghost fire will take that prayer and expand something in your life. And your life will never be the same again. That's my encouragement for you this moment. Please, let this time be a time to rejoice. A time to draw close to God. A time to let God be glorified. A time to shine the light of God. Is somebody out there this morning that is saying, you know, Pastor William, I've been through a lot. You don't know my story. I've been through a lot in my life. I have gone through many, many things. Things are so bad for me right now, Pastor. I don't know what to do anymore. Friend, I'm going to pray with you right now. But I can assure you one thing. God will never leave you nor forsake you. The government may not give you what you need, but God will never leave you nor forsake you. But you know what I come to realize? The Bible says, the secrets of the Lord are with those that fear him. How do you fear him if you don't know him? You only get to know him through his word and through prayer. So the moment you get that in your spirit, things begin to change in your life. That is why anyone that encounters the Lord, I say it over and over again, any man that encounters God will never remain the same. You may encounter church. You may encounter a pastor. That's okay. But when you encounter God, your whole life will never remain the same. Depression, we have no choice but to bow down. Spirit of adultery, we have no choice but to bow down. Demonic power, we have no choice but to bow down. Everything will bow down to the name above all things because you've experienced Christ. Let's pray. Father, I don't know who is watching. I don't know how many people are there watching, but you know them. Lord, I pray right now for every single one that they will make that time. They make that time for you. They will decide to go into their prayer closet and be prayer warriors. They will decide to be prayer warriors. They will decide to be a man or a woman that trusts in the name of the Lord. They will decide to be men or women that will glorify. Father God, I pray that, oh God, there will be decision making today, right now, Lord Jesus, that the family, that the man that pushes his children away will not start drawing them closer and make your face to shine upon them, oh God. Lord, I pray that everyone hearing the sound of my voice will rise up to the challenge that this is a time to fight for our family, a time to fight for what we believe, a time to fight for everything in prayer and the word. Thank you for helping them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. The last thing I want to say, make time. You can make time. In your break time, when you are working from home, make time to be with your children. In the early morning time, make time to do family devotion with your children. At night time, before they go to bed, make time to pray with your family. Pray, pray, pray. And let us make time to be together with our great and our mighty God. May God bless you, my brother and my sister. May God encourage you. May God strengthen you. And may you continue to do greater things for the kingdom of God. I salute you all. I bless the name of the Lord. Please, if we can be of blessing to you, please send us an email. Send us a message. Our administrator is already there. We'll contact you. We'll be able to be of a prayer to you. If you are sick, if you have any, what you're going through, we are here as family to be of a blessing to you. May God bless you. Remember, Jesus loves you. And so do we. God bless and shalom. Amen. We'll be back again next time. Bye. Hi, everybody. Thank you for choosing to watch this video. We thank you because we believe that God has connected us for this reason. Can I encourage you to please find time to subscribe to our channel and the like and the channel and the videos, because every subscription we get, if we get to about 1,000 of them, we can be able to broadcast better through YouTube. And the YouTube requires that we get about 1,000 subscriptions. So tell your friends, tell your neighbor to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are so excited and so blessed to bring this word to you. It's the word of the living God, and it's our privilege to encourage the body of Christ. So please press this subscribe button and subscribe, and also like our page on YouTube. May God bless you, and we look forward to catching up with you. If you ever need us to pray for you, please send your prayer request through the live broadcast, because we have monitors that monitor all these things and send them to our prayer request team. God bless you all. Thank you for liking our videos, and thank you for subscribing. Together, we will reach that 1,000 subscribers so we can be able to broadcast more for God's glory. In Jesus' name, amen.